Hi friends, let me start by saying that I'm a resident of NRI complex. And why am I sitting out here? I just managed to go to the AGM by chance. And while sitting out there, I realized that when the discussion came to the repair committee, repairing budget, it was 20 crores. And a certain section said that this is too high. Now, being from an engineering background and also an interested resident, I joined the repair committee. And after going through 15 sessions of the committee, I realized that the estimate is made very systematically and scientifically. And I would like one of you all to please elaborate.
So, aaj hum log milke baithe hain idhar. There is an issue about the estimation. And the residents will like to make a decision. Ki building repairs or painting ka kharcha hona kitna chahiye. Aur is pure process ko wo kis tarah se support kar sakte hain. So, there has been an estimate made by ACL through a very renowned consultant, Shindre, as per which the approximate cost of repair and painting is about 20 crores. Now, some people have come up with the idea that this work can be done in 10 crores. Mr. Narayan, will you like to start with giving a background?
Yes. So just on that point, to my understanding though, I'm not a technical person, so take me as speaking from a layman person. I, as a resident here, I could be willing to spend 1 lakh, 1.5 lakh, but I want to make sure that that is genuinely used. And only so much of money has been taken from me as has been required. So therefore, I would like to have clarity and a better understanding from you as to how this whole estimation would actually work.
So, are you saying that your concern is primarily about how the money will be spent and what is the process in which you can play as a resident a role in it, right?
Absolutely. Yeah.
Right. Understand. But now, you see, the point is that we are at an age of about 20 years, and what do you think is the condition of the buildings? What do you think about the technical aspects on why we need the repairs and whether we need the repairs in the first place or not?
So actually in Mumbai, because of the fact that we are next to the sea and there is a marine environment, so typically reinforced concrete buildings in Mumbai require one round of major rehabilitation around 15 to 20 years after construction. So it is not surprising that the consultant has found that this complex buildings also require a major rehabilitation. Now the rehabilitation itself would have two parts. One is taking care of the structural repair needs which have been identified, and the overall cost of that should not be very large. And then the second component would be actually carrying out things like painting and other works which are associated with improving the ambience of the complex, but not really directly related to the structural repair of the buildings. So actually the consultant has also given the breakup of the cost on the basis of both the cost required for structural repairs and the cost required for the other works to be carried out.
So, can we make two categories out of the works that are to be done? There are certain items where I believe there will be no changes in the quantity. For example, we will have scaffolding where there will be no change in the quantity. The painting quantities will remain fixed. So, I think the issue is now in quantifying about items like concrete and plastering, because unless the technicians get an access and they remove all the loose materials, you will not be able to actually quantify what is the work to be done. Is that so?
Yeah, that is a common practice, that when you do the preliminary assessment, you are not able to assess the exact quantity of work which is required to be done. And that is why the normal practice in this particular field is that when you award a contract, you award the contract on item rate basis. So without quantifying what is the actual volume of work which has to be done. And then when the work starts and you start doing the close inspection and actually removing the plaster to inspect what is behind it, then as you go, you fix the actual quantity of work to be done. So it is very important that the contract should be awarded on item rate basis, say on the per square meter of surface area, and per kg of consumption of various kinds of material, and closely monitor the work so that excess amount of work is not awarded or is not paid for if it was not required to be done.
So you're saying that there are two components, one is a fixed component and one is a variable component.
These are on the quantities.
On the quantity side.
Yes.
So would you have any idea as to in the overall cost, what could be the percentage of the fixed component?
Yeah, so if you go item by item, the very first item is about the scaffolding. So you need a double bamboo scaffolding, and then you need protections. You need protection for all the windows through plywood, then you have a dust protection, and then you also have a vertical three-layer system vertical protection where all the debris will fall on. So you know, this is amounting to about 18% of the total cost. We have an estimate of about 20 crores, and in the last 15 meetings we have gone through the estimate many times. We have actually got to the buildings and found that the estimate seems to be quite realistic based on the backup that has been given by the consultant.
Yeah.
So about 18% goes for the scaffolding and the protection system, and then we have about 25% which is accounting for the painting. And then we have items like repair of concrete and repair of plastering, which vary. For the plastering, I think it is about 15%. And then we have about 18 to 20% which is going for the structural repairs. Now, in these two items, there may be some variation in the quantities, because when the technicians actually go to the field and they to the building, and they actually have to remove all the loose materials.
So then I would like to add that the disparity of cost which is there of 10 crores and 20 crores, there is no reason for disparity. If we are only looking at the quantities and we are going to float tenders openly in the market, so whether it is 10 crores, it will remain 10, and if 20 comes down to whatever, it will be a very open system. So where is the disparity?
Yeah, actually that is the point, that we should not look at the total cost as what we expect to spend. We should look at the total cost as a plan. And the consultant, when we interacted with, the consultant said that he has been involved in giving similar advice to dozens of buildings in the city.
I think he's a very reputed consultant. He has done prestigious projects in the city.
Yeah, right? What he mentioned was that he always gives a slight overestimation, because it is quite difficult to go back to the residents and ask for more money later on. So it is. He said that in all the projects which he has done earlier, the actual cost was lower than what he had estimated. And he said that there is no reason why it would not happen over here. So the key point again is that we should not give a fixed cost contract, we should give item rate contract, and closely monitor the work going on to ensure that only that work which is required is executed.
So that way, I think we'll be controlling the cost ourselves, right?
Yes.
The residents and the resident committee will be controlling the cost.
Yeah, I think that is what is it is coming down to, that the residents have to be involved in the work which is carried out. It cannot be totally outsourcing job.
I think that's what the current committee is all about. I think there are hardly any board of directors. They are mostly residents who have taken the initiative and they have become members of the committee.
The way the work will be carried out is based on a joint effort by the residents and the building repair committee. We will have a matrix where the residents will be offering their volunteering services. So the functional requirements will be met by the staffing that will be done. As also the residents can play a very vital role. They can very well go and ask how these quantities are determined and what work is being done, how much materials are being consumed. So it's a very open and transparent process.
And what goes out from a resident's pocket, there's nothing like surplus being taken out, because there's no surplus to be generated at SEL account.
Right.
If the money, let's say we agree on a certain monthly figure, and if the money is required only for 18 months, the money will be taken for 18 months. If the money is equivalent to 24 months, the money will be only taken for 24 months.
Let's all get together, put our energies together, and let us make these building repairs happen. Itne sundar complex mein hum log reh rahe hain, itna sa jo kharcha bahar ke liye karna hai, that is essential. Let's do it.